In this episode, we have with us Mr. S.Inderjit Singh Bala. S.Inderjit Singh Bala retired as a lecturer of English and has since started cycling and is now the chairman of the District Cycling Association of Ropar, which is a city near Chandigarh in Punjab, where he currently resides. Today, he is going to share the joy of cycling and why cycling should be your best friend. Very good morning, sir. How are you, sir?
Fine, sir.
Most welcome, sir. Most welcome. So, sir, with your permission, I will straight away start with the questions. Sir, you come from a traditional farming family and have lived in Behrampur Zamindara, a village in Ropar district, for a very long time. Now, as you live in an urbanized city setting, how has life been? Why is it that city dwellers long for villages and villagers, on the other hand, long for cities?
Yes, I am from a traditional farming family, but to decide to reside in city, that is due to cities. We feel that there is very good prospects in cities. So, but today when I am in city, I feel that villages are also good. So, comparatively city, and if I am comparing my village, both are, I feel, equally. So, what a decision to come to the city, that I feel equally, just like our village.
Absolutely. So now, you know, I want to ask you this question regarding the villages of Punjab. How do you think the villages of Punjab have evolved over time? How much change is there in the lifestyle happening right now? Is village still, you know, as we thought before, is it still a isolated, naive and an innocent as people would perceive it, sir?
If I honestly speak, my village situated on a national highway near Chandigarh, having all facilities like cities. So I think our villages, mostly in Punjab, are different from the traditional villages of India. I visited other states and villages are just like cities. All facilities which we have in city, we have in our village.
Absolutely. Now, sir, you know, I want to ask you regarding, you know, your choice of cycling after retirement. Why did you choose cycling after retirement? Is it a fitness thing? Is it a leisure thing? Or is it like something else or a combination of two or more factors? Tell us about your cycling and why did you start it?
Not after retirement. I start 4 or 5 years ago. That was only a...
Sir, ek minute, I repeat karunga answer. Sir, answer repeat kar dunga, please.
Yes.
Please. Hanji, bolo ji.
Yes. Hi, okay. I start only for fitness with my son. Not after retirement, I started. Four or 5 years ago, but now at present we enjoy different trips, so now it's a enjoyment also, and first we think that it's a good for physical fitness, so we feel that it's good for health.
Understood. So, you know, sir, there's a concern of, you know, cycling in Punjab. We see like there's a road safety issue. So how do you manage the fears around road safety for cyclists when you go for cycling trips, especially in the highways of Punjab?
It's a very good question. I, being a Sikh, I always wear a helmet. Last week, I fell from the cycle and helmet broke up. So that saves me from the head injury. So helmet is very compulsory for a cyclist because traffic rules are obeyed by the people, not in Punjab, throughout India. Roads are not very good. So actually we mostly prefer the instead of national highways to the local roads. But wearing helmet compulsory, not very safe. We are not totally safe. We prefer early in the morning when the traffic is always less on roads.
Understood, sir. Understood. There is this district cyclic association that you are part of, and you have also organized, you know, this very important Tour de Ropar on the lines of Tour de France. Please tell the viewers about Tour de Ropar.
Tour de Ropar, I am being a chairman, and my other members do very good job. We follow the Bathinda Cycling Association, and Mr. Gurpreet Singh, who is the very energetic member of our DCA, District Cycling Association. He managed the program. So we totally success. 150 cyclists from different parts of Punjab, Himachal and Chandigarh participated in that event. So I think that promotes the cycling in our district. And I proudly say at present we are having more than 300 cyclists in our district. And they are having different groups. So I think that efforts which I and my son is the best companion of me. We both, son and father, known for cycling in our district. So that our effort, I think, very successful. People follow us. Sadi jodi mashhoor hai in Punjabi. Hindi mein kahunge, baap aur bete ki jodi pure district mein mashhoor hai ke all around city, all villagers known us by these are the helmet wearing people. I'm giving a good message.
I'm so glad. I'm so glad that, you know, Tour de Ropar was organized and you did such good work in, you know, creating awareness and, you know, keeping so many cyclists together so that they can do an event together. Now, regarding the other activities of District Cyclic Association, so do you think that cycling is also about bonding and sharing? And did all the members of the cycling association meet during the pandemic?
Due to Corona, we suspend at present all our activities. Group cycling, we avoid group cycling since last 3 months. But individually, our cyclists are doing their jobs. But after that tour, the Ropar, we haven't done any program. So it's a setback for us due to Corona.
I can understand.
Pandemic ends, we start again.
I can understand. So I hope the pandemic ends soon, and you know, all the activities and the cycling trips of your association and of the groups in Punjab can start really, really soon. Apart from the group cycling, where all have you gone for cycling? Please tell us about your trips, the distance traveled, the time taken, and the joy that you experienced in such trips.
I am 60 years old. So my youngsters, which are the member of DCA, they traveled Himachal, Shimla, and all Punjab, Delhi. So they having lot of tour programs in past, but I mostly use to go near small trips. Whole district I have traveled, and now at present last we traveled to up to Delhi, San Porcha. That was my longest journey by cycle.
So, sir, you spoke about the... Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. Please go ahead.
My son and Damad, both we start at 5. I long to travel up to Kisan Porcha in one day. The distance was about 250 kilometers. So we start at 5 from Ropar and reach at 8 p.m. at Delhi. So that was a courageous act from my side in the age of 60. I feel proud that and had a message. Our that Surkhab TV interview ली थी उन्होंने तो उसमें 60 साला बापू दामाद ते बेटे नाल मोर्चे ते पहुंचा मोर देन नियर अबाउट 10 के पीपल हैज वॉच दैट वीडियो सो आई फील गुड आफ्टर दैट एंड नेक्स्ट डे वी कम बैक. So within 2 days, we traveled more than 500 kilometers.
That's amazing, sir. So you cycled from Punjab to Delhi during the initial phases of the farm protest. And why did you choose to cycle is one question. The other question is, do you think it is a way of activism and raising public awareness?
Yes, I honestly say cycling, first it's good for health. So I decided to travel by cycle to Morcha to spread a message to our retirees and the person, those who were sitting in homes after retirement, okay, why not we can do this? So I choose cycle. And along with my son and my son-in-law, Damad. So it was a courageous act. I decided that I would go to one day. So it was a difficult job for us. We carry our meal with us. So next day we come back. Within 2 days we traveled more than 500 kilometers. So in the age of 60 it was a spread message.
So to ask you this question, is cycling a good way of activism to spread a message? You know, like to raise voice of the people. So can people use it as a tool for protest?
Not a tool for protest. No, aisa nahi kar sakta. Cycling as we not done as a protest. But main ek message ye bhi dena chahta tha ki Punjab se Delhi itna dur nahi hai ki हम वहां प्रोटेस्ट के लिए पहुंच नहीं सकते कि हम साइकिल पे भी एक दिन में वहां जा सकते हैं. सो बाय साइकिलिंग टू रीच द आउटस्किर्ट्स ऑफ दिल्ली गिव अ मैसेज टू द पंजाबीज कि दिल्ली दूर नहीं है. It's not far away from us. So, Jaita ji travel by and taking our Jish of Guru Tegh Bahadur. That was also a very courageous act. So, Delhi, Punjab se dur nahi hai. So, ye, that was a main cause to travel up to Delhi by cycle.
Absolutely. Thank you for that answer. And I'm sure all the Punjabis who have watched you in the other channels and who have seen you, you know, cycling to Delhi, they would have been inspired. And also they would have felt even they should start cycling. So with respect to, you know, motivating others to cycle, how should a person new to cycling start cycling? What are the requirements? What is the way forward? Tell us about how should we start cycling.
I think if at an initial stage, a person उसको पहले अपना जो simple cycle से start करना चाहिए, not to spend much money on gear cycles that cost near about 15,000-20,000. Person became used to, जब वो used to हो जाए तब उसे बढ़िया cycle खरीदना चाहिए. So feel that those people buy costly cycle during pandemic last year, they mostly have left the cycling. So that is the financial loss. So first, used to hona bahut zaruri hai. Mostly people buy costly cycles at initial stage that they were not used to. So I think or I am watching during last 2-3 months, and during pandemic mostly people buy cycles, very costly cycles, but now they have not in use. So first to make a routine, and the person when became user of the and have a habit, so then he try to buy he or she cycle. So it's a good if people enjoying this and buying cycle, and the cycle industry's boom is also good message for Indian people, mostly for Punjabis.
Thank you. So, sir, it was, you know, great talking to you. We spoke about a lot of things regarding life in Punjab, regarding why you chose cycling after retirement, regarding the fears around road safety, regarding the all the activities, including the Tour de Ropar and the other, you know, great initiatives of the Cycling Association of Ropar. Now, sir, my final request to you would be to give a message to the viewers to inspire them.
I at present enjoying cycling, and I having a painting, taste in painting, gardening, growing vegetable for my own kitchen, and I am having a poetry book, Yada and Friyada. So I message the people, those who having any taste or un mein kuch na kuch hai, so they don't die empty. So if we have a taste in music, we have a any passion, so try to explore, expose to do that for their happiness. The real happiness, I think, is in the taste and the like-minded. If you try to live in the like-minded people, so I think in our society, we are lacking of this. Our people are not aware about these days, painting, writing, reading, and gardening. I believe in physical exertion also. Man is not made to sit idle. We are from jungle. So do active jobs. So I like to live actively. Physical exertion is necessary for good life. So I think and I believe in first physical exertion and philosophy of our Guru, Guru Nanak Dev Ji, being a Sikh, that given a message us in 500 years ago to live in Kartarpur and do agriculture in the last days. So we are from soil. We are born from soil and last we are the part of that soil. Mitti hai, mitti ho jana hai. Or love to doing work in soil. That is, I feel ajaya lagta hai that time ki hum jahan se aaye wahan ja rahe. So I love gardening and I have more than 25 fruit trees and I always grow my vegetables for use and cycling, writing, painting. I always busy and never long to become a famous and never to make a jugaad to become a popular. Now, so I honestly say we I like to live isolated or but naturally when we are living in a positively in our society, you naturally became an example. So during my job I done my honestly my teaching job. English isn't our mother language. Being a lecturer, I mostly, it's an incident to become a lecturer in English. So I like to write and read in Punjabi.
No, thank you. Thank you. I think, you know, you have given a very important message regarding cycling, regarding, you know, like what should people do after retirement, you know, particularly the physical activity and cycling that you spoke about and all the other activities. You're into reading, you're into writing, you're into gardening and other so many other pursuits that you are into. And I really, really, you know, from the bottom of my heart, want to thank you because you took time out and shared your life with us. And, you know, I'm sure this video is going to inspire a lot of people. Thank you so much.